Praise the Lord, everybody. We're preaching Jesus. We're so grateful to be together again on this morning. We come together to worship the Lord and the beauty of His holiness. We thank God for you joining us on today. Thank you for taking your time out. We're going to invite you to praise the Lord along with us as we worship, as we give God praises that is due unto His name. We ask that you would share. We ask that you would like and just let it be known what we're doing here on this morning, because we're going to have a great time in the Lord. We thank God for each and every one of you. We thank God for Him bringing us all through this week. We're going to pray in the name of Jesus. Amen. And then we're going to get into our worship on this morning. Amen. But I want to go ahead and just ask you, amen, to clap your hands along with us. The praise of the Lord along with us, lift up your voice wherever you might be. Amen. You can always give God praise. Amen. Because God is everywhere. We may not be in the sanctuary together, but God is everywhere. We can worship the Lord anywhere we are. Amen. So we're grateful, amen, that you've joined us. And we ask you to join with us and worship the Lord with us today in Jesus' name. Let us bow before the Lord, amen, and ask His blessings upon this gathering in Jesus' name. Lord, we thank you today for your blessings. We thank you, God, for all that you've done. We thank you for keeping us. Lord, throughout this week, you allow no hurt, harm, or danger to come upon us, Lord. We thank you for your protection on the highways, on the byways, on the jobs, wherever we have been, Lord. You have been with us. You have watched over us. You have protected us. Oh, God, you have kept us through all kinds of dangers, seen and unseen, Lord. We give you praises for it on this morning, God. God, we now come and we seek your face. We pray, God, that you would bless this gathering, oh God, the service right now. Let your word go forth. Let your praise come up to you as a sweet smelling savor. Oh God, move, Lord, in our midst right now, God, for those who are in the sanctuary, those, oh God, who will join us by Facebook. God, we pray that you to bless and touch the hearts right now, God, that they may feel your anointing and your presence and your power in the name of Jesus Christ. God, these things we ask, God, we praise you in advance. But what you're going to do, it seems to ask in Jesus' name, amen, 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 amen. We're going to sing a song, amen, before the Lord, amen. And this song says, I will bless the Lord, and I will bless the Lord. No matter what's going on in your life, know that you can bless God at all times, amen. And know that His praise shall ever and continuously be in your mouth. No matter what's going on, amen, God's praise is continuously in my mouth. Amen. So sing along with us, amen. Let me sing a song. Amen. I will bless the Lord.
Cause I will bless the Lord. Sometimes, as human beings in our prayer team, we don't always come up to that. So God sometimes gives us a token, help us along the way. And one of the most natural tokens I can think of is the rainbow. It's a promise that God made at the beginning of time that he would never flood the earth again. And even sometimes in our natural walk, we need tokens to help our faith, because God asks us to move from faith to faith. So we pray and hope that you sung these songs and the message that's coming today will help you just that, move from faith to faith.
Come on and bless the Lord with me. Come on and bless the Lord with me. Come on and bless the Lord.
Come on and bless the Lord with me. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Come on, let's give the Lord one more praise. We praise you, we bless him. We magnify the name of our God. Amen. He is worthy of our praise. Amen. Again, we thank each and one for joining us on this morning on Facebook. We thank God for everyone who is here in the sanctuary and few that are here. Amen. With us, amen, to worship. Amen. And we thank God for you, you and you. Amen. We thank God for our worship team on this morning. Amen. Yes. Amen. Keep us. Praise the Lord. Amen. For the presence of the Lord. And we want to get into the word on this morning, but we want to do remind you that this week, amen, is Holy Convocation. Amen. And the topic, the theme is, amen, God does all things well. Amen. We have this coming up on Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. This week, the 17th to the 19th, we invite each and every one of you to join us by Facebook, or you can drive in. We have a tent set up here, and we will allow you to drive in because it's going to be taking place outside, amen. And so we are excited, amen, so we'll still have a live experience, amen, being able to come together, amen. We'll stay in our cars, we'll still be masked. Some may sit on the lawn if they like, amen. But we are going to be here together, amen. We're going to have the church open for someone, anybody in use of facilities or anything like that. Amen. It's going to be totally sanitary and cleansed. Amen. So you don't have to worry about anything like that. Amen. We'll still be social distancing. Amen. But we're going to be able to come together. Amen. It's going to start 7 o'clock nightly, and we're going to be done before 9. All right, 7 o'clock nightly, done before 9 o'clock, amen, just as it is about to get dark, amen. This is all in consideration of our neighbors, amen, and your time, amen. So we are going, we're excited about the Lord, amen. Join us Wednesday, Thursday, Friday this week, amen, as we go into our Holy Convocation. We're still going to have a high and great time in the Lord when we come together, amen. We are excited in Jesus' name, amen. We are excited. So we may not be here on Tuesday, but we are going to be doing little things. So look out for us on Facebook, amen, pertaining to our convocation. And we're going to speak today, amen, just for a little while. And the next couple of times I do this on Facebook during the week here, it's going to be on kind of like the same wavelength. So it's almost like a series, amen. But we are going to be getting started on today. Amen. So we are grateful. We're going to actually turn with us to the book of St. Matthew.
Yes.
Book of St. Matthew and chapter number 6. St. Matthew, chapter number 6 and the 10th verse.
Yes, yes.
Amen. Amen. St. Matthew chapter number 6.
Yes, yes.
And the 10th verse. Amen. As soon as I can get it. Amen. Praise the Lord.
All right.
Amen. But it's just that one verse we're going to talk from that. Amen. On this morning. Amen. It says, and this is the prayer of Jesus. This is prayer as Jesus is teaching his disciples. Amen. They say, Lord, Master, teach us how to pray.
Yes.
And this is included in the prayer. Amen. We know, we all know of what we call the Our Father's Prayer. Amen. But the 10th verse I want to highlight, it says, Thy kingdom come, thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven.
Amen.
Amen. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven. Lord, we thank you for this time, this opportunity to be among your people. Thank you for your presence. Thank you for the worship. Thank you, God, for everyone who is joining us on this morning. God, we pray for something to say to bless and to touch and to heal, to deliver somebody on today, Lord. Bless us now as only you can, Lord, for you are our people, you are our strength. Lord, I pray that you will help me to decrease, and I pray that you will increase in me right now, God, and in this house, God. Bless God as only you can in the name of Jesus Christ. Pray, amen.
Amen.
Amen. I'm speaking, amen, from that verse, amen, thy kingdom come, amen. And this part of the series, amen, is melted majesty. Somebody say melted majesty. Yeah, you don't understand what I'm saying a little bit, amen, it's fine. Melted majesty, amen. This scripture and the word of God, amen, throughout the scripture lets us know that God's kingdom is going to come upon the earth. Now, his disciples, the followers of Jesus, were looking for a physical kingdom right away. Amen. They were looking for Jesus to establish a kingdom, amen, to overrule the Roman rulership that was going on in Israel at the time, to come in and to tear down the enemies and to overcome. Amen. But Jesus let them know, I have not come for that yet. Amen. That time will come. But that time is not now, amen. But the kingdom that I'm going to establish now is going to begin now, amen. And I'm going to make sure that the kingdom of God is in you, amen. Somebody say that, amen. The kingdom of God is in you. Amen. So, amen, I'm not going to establish some earthly kingdom. I'm not going to establish some earthly rule. But, amen, what I'm going to do is put my kingdom in people. Amen. And kingdom says, listen, kingdom means, a kingdom is to be under the rulership of a king or a queen. Amen. It is centered around one person. And that kingdom, that those people are the subject and they serve the will of the king. Amen. And so when we're talking about the kingdom of God, amen, we're talking about the rule of God, amen, in the life of the believer. Amen. And in the life, amen, in the kingdoms of the world, amen, it is the rule of God. Amen. So I want to deal with that on this morning, amen, because God wants to first of all establish his kingdom in his people. Amen. And then the people of the kingdom will represent the kingdom, amen, and bring that kingdom into the earth. Amen. How that is the job of the church of God, to bring forth the kingdom of God in the earth. Amen. So God, his method has always been a man. His method has always been an individual. Amen. And we wonder, why won't God just come and just overrule and to take over everything? Amen. But God said, I'm going to use man. Amen. Even when it came to salvation, amen, he didn't just send salvation. Amen. He came in the form of a man. He came in flesh. Amen. So he had to do it through manhood. So God's method has always been to use a man. Look down through history. Look through, amen, the scripture. Amen. God, amen, always uses a man. He used Moses. He used Elijah to speak. Amen. He used, amen, an individual. Amen. So God does not come direct through us many times, but God will come, amen, through people. Amen. And people is his method. Amen. How do you believe that God's method is people? Come on. People is his method. So as I read the scripture, amen, I begin to consider, amen, that God, the prayer was, thy kingdom come. Amen. Now we're living in the world, but the Bible says we're not of the world. And so, amen, when we receive the baptism of the Holy Ghost, we come, amen, to know God for ourselves. Amen. His kingdom is first of all established in us. Amen. So my question is to you, amen, whose rule are you under? Whose rule are you under? Amen. Who is the head of your life? I know we got the testimony, amen, first given unto God, amen, who is the head of my life, amen. Thank God for the pastor, saints, and the friends, amen. But I wonder, is God really the ruler of our life? Is he really, are we really operating under the kingdom, amen, rulership? Amen. We need to ask ourselves the question today, amen, everybody, amen, am I really under the rulership of the king? Because if I'm under the rulership of the king, amen, that means I walk in obedience. That means that, amen, everything that I do is for the sake of the king. Everything that I do, my thoughts, amen, my actions, amen, my words, they all go forth to promote the kingdom. Amen. So I believe that first of all, the kingdom of God has to be really established in the people of God, amen, before the kingdom of God can go into the world. The scripture says in Luke 17 and 21,
Amen. The kingdom of God is in you. The kingdom of God is in you. Amen. So the rulership of God, amen, the establishment of God's authority is supposed to be first displayed in those who are called to be sanctified. Amen. And so our prayer needs to be today, Lord, help me to be under your rulership. Help me to submit myself. Help me to bring myself under. Help me to be submitted to your will. Lord, help my walks and my step and my speech and my thoughts and everything that is, pertains to me, God. Help me to be that it will be under your rulership. Amen. And we submit ourselves. And the Bible says if we submit ourselves, God will begin to exalt us. Amen. And God is calling for submission. Amen. First of all, from his people. Because, amen, we cannot expect the world to do anything until we ourselves submit under the rulership of the King. Amen. So, Lord, help me to be under your rulership. Help me to submit myself. Help me to humble myself under your mighty hand. Amen. Because I want to make sure, oh God, that when I go out, I represent your King. Amen. Somebody say rulership. Amen. It is the authority of God. Amen. There was an authority that must be established. Amen. In us. Amen. How do we do it? Amen. We do it through our prayer life. We do it through our word life. Amen. We do it through our fast life. Amen. We submit ourselves unto God. Amen. We want to be in a position that when we go somewhere and God is able to speak to us. Amen. God is able to say, amen, pray for this person. God is able to say, give that personal word, amen. It don't have to be your brother or sister. It could be somebody on the street, amen. That's because the kingdom of God being in you, it goes out, amen. It's not just to be in the sanctuary. God is established, amen. And so, amen, every time we go and we minister to somebody's being, amen, the kingdom of God is being established in the earth. It is being established in the earth. So when you pray for that person, pray for that person in the grocery store at a restaurant, amen. Or you give that encouraging word, or you tell somebody that Jesus saves, amen. You are doing something great, amen. You are planting seeds of the kingdom, amen, in the earth, amen. And every time somebody gets saved, every time somebody gets delivered, every time somebody gets blessed, amen, it's a little bit more of the kingdom of God in the earth. And how do you know we need more now than ever the kingdom of God to be established in the earth? These are rough times. Amen. These are difficult times. Amen. A lot is going on in the world. Amen. And no more now than ever. Amen. We need God's kingdom. Amen. To bless the world. We need God's kingdom to speak. Amen. To the things that are going on in the world. Amen. My message today, amen, is first of all to the church of God. Because we must, amen, learn how to let God's kingdom be established in us. Amen. And here is my message. Here is my message, amen. As I said, amen, we're talking about, amen, Milton Majesty. Listen, amen, back in 1776, amen, the 4th of July, amen. Anybody know what the 4th of July is? What do we celebrate 4th of July? Independence Day, right? Amen. Independence Day, amen. Independence Day was set forth, amen, on the 4th of July because that is when the Declaration of Independence was penned, amen. But listen, amen, when the Declaration was written, amen, that did not mean that they were free, amen. It was just a declaration, amen, because the 13 colonies or 13 states, as they were, amen, they were under the rulership of Great Britain, amen, a great and mighty nation. And they, the 13 states, amen, decided, amen, they did not want to be under that anymore, amen. So they wrote the Declaration of Independence, amen, letting Britain know, letting the world know, amen, we're not going to be under this rulership anymore. Amen. How many of you got to make a declaration? So, on July the 9th, amen, the Declaration of Independence was written, was read to, amen, troops in New York, amen. And after the Declaration of Independence, amen, and history tells us that the soldiers and sailors, they went out of that place that it was read, and there
They're in the center of in Bowling Green in Manhattan. There was a great statue of King George. And King George III, amen, being king of Britain, amen, that statue represented, amen, the rulership. It represented, amen, Britain's authority. Amen. And what the troops did, y'all, was they tore down that statue. They took down the statue. Amen. And we wonder why taking down statues is might be important in the United States right now. Amen. But those statues represent something. They represent something. Amen. And they represent it. And so what they did, they tore down the statue of King George III. Amen. They ripped it down. And what they did, they took parts of that statue and they began to melt that statue. Listen to me, amen. They melted it. And history tells us, amen, from the melted lead and metal that they got from that, they began to make, they made 42,000 musket balls. A musket ball was a bullet from that day on. It was round, amen. Musket balls. They made these musket balls, amen, from that statue. Amen. 42,000. Amen. And these 42,000 musket balls were going to be used to shoot at the enemy. Come on. It was going to be used in the war against the enemy, amen. And that melted down of that statue, amen, of that majesty became known as melted majesty. Amen. And so my point today is, amen, God has blessed. I look at people of God everywhere today in the church of God. Amen. Sometimes there are things and sometimes there are statues. Sometimes there are things that are established in us, amen, that should not be there. Yeah, but I come to tell us, amen, it's time to tear it down right now. It's time to tear it down right now. Amen. Take down the statue. Take down the thing of bondage. Amen. That which represents your bondage. That which represents that thing that is holding you. Amen. It might be fear. It may be doubt. It may be jealousy. Amen. It may be all kinds of things. It may be abuse that we suffer. Amen. But sometimes these things will come into our life and they will be statues. And even though we're trying to be independent, we're trying to be, amen, on our own, we're trying to serve God with all that we have, yet we still have these statues. Amen. Even some things that are secretive that nobody else knows about. Amen. But these things are statues that are erected in our life. Amen. That represent our bondage. But in the name of Jesus, if we are truly be a people of God, a kingdom people, we have to be able to tear down the statue. Amen. And even after tearing down the statue, you got to learn how to use what power you. And you got to learn how to use it to come against the enemy. Amen. You got to learn how to turn around what power you. You'll be able to take what power you, amen, and use it against the devil. See, sometimes when they were secretive, amen, about what we've been through, you have to tell all your business. Amen. But if God has brought you through a thing, amen, God will allow you, amen, to take that thing that bound you before. And God is able to turn around, amen, for your favor. It becomes your testimony. It becomes your strength. Amen. And your bondage becomes your weapon. Amen. Have no God help you turn your bondage into a weapon. Yeah, yeah, amen. See, the same thing that they had pounded with and that representative, amen, they begin to shoot at the enemy. Amen. They begin to come against a great army of Britain. Amen. See, amen. See, this country was very young, amen, not really strong. Amen. And Britain was still a great power. Amen. They were a mighty army. Amen. They had a great navy. Amen. They had great soldiers. And these colonies were not supposed to be in the wind. Amen. But listen, they fought. I said they fought. Amen. And they got the victory. They got victory. Amen. Because they were able to turn that thing around and say, we will not be in bondage anymore. Amen. We're coming out of this bondage. We're coming out of them and everything that represents it. Amen. Because listen, you can't afford to be bound right now. Come on, I say you cannot afford to be bound right now. I'm almost done, amen. But God is saying to us, amen, you got to loose yourself, amen, from the bondage of your mind. You got to loose yourself, amen, from the bondage of your spirit. You got to loose yourself. Amen. I know they told you were ugly. I know they talk bad about you. Amen. But I come to tell you, God is able to turn things around. Amen. You got to learn to look in the mirror and Amen. Look at yourself and say, you sharp. If nobody else don't tell you. Amen. Look at yourself in the mirror and say, I am beautiful. I am handsome. Amen. Amen. I'm looking good right now. And you carry yourself that way. Not because you know who you are. Amen. I don't know who you are. Amen. I'm not talking about walking around in pride. Amen. I'm talking about walking around and knowing who you are in God. Come on. Amen. I know who I am. Amen. So the enemy uses all these things. He uses all these things. Amen. He'll mess up marriages from past relationships. Come on. Amen. He will mess up friendships. Amen. Because, man, one friendship fell apart. He will mess up all kind of relationships because something else went wrong. Amen. But I come to tell you, amen, you got to learn how to release yourself, amen, from that bondage. Because I can't afford to be bound. Amen. And I know who my enemy is. And the Bible said we're not wrestling against the flesh and blood, but against principalities and powers. Amen. You fight the wrong kind of fight. Amen. You better know who the fight is against. Come on, somebody. Amen. Know who your fight is against. As I end, amen, I want to think about Joseph. The Bible says, amen, Joseph was in prison. He was locked up. His brothers sold him into slavery. His brothers sold him out. Amen. And he ends up in Egypt. Y'all hear this. He ends up in Egypt. In Egypt, he ends up in the house of Potiphar. Amen. We know the story. He's falsely accused. Amen. He goes to jail. Amen. Can you imagine climbing the ladder, amen, even to be in Potiphar's house and trusting, amen, over the man's house, amen, and all of a sudden, amen, something happens that you didn't even do. Amen. He was accused of something he didn't even do. And he ends up in jail. Amen. He tells dreams in the jail. And he tells these people to look out for me. Amen. When you get out. Amen. But you know what they did when they got out? They forgot about him. Amen. He helped them get out of jail. Amen. He helped them, amen, know what's coming in the future. Amen. And when they got their freedom, amen, they forgot about him. Amen. But listen, amen, and all the stuff that he went through, amen, to make a long story short, amen, all the stuff that he went through, amen, we know that he did not get bitter and bent out of shape about what he went through. He didn't get messed up over what he went through. Because if he was messed up over what he went through, he would have taken an opportunity, amen, to do something to his brothers. To the point where he said, you meant it for evil, but God meant it for good, amen. You thought you were setting me out. You thought you were doing me wrong. Amen. But God, amen, turned that thing out to be good. And the dream that I had, amen, you actually helped fulfill the dream that God gave me. Amen. So that's why I'm telling you, amen, even when things come against you, amen, if you know how to turn it right, if you know how to treat it right, amen, if you know how to weaponize that thing, you can take that and use it against the enemy. Come on, somebody. That's why you cannot afford to be bitter. You cannot afford to be upset. You cannot afford it, amen, because we know, amen, that even this works out for my good. Somebody say, this is working for my good. The stuff that I went through is working for my good. The stuff that I suffered is working even for my good. Amen. Listen, amen. If he had his brothers, amen, he had an opportunity now. That is what humility is. Amen. He had the opportunity to destroy his brothers. And we might think that his brothers was the enemy. But the enemy at this time, saints, was famine. The enemy was famine. And famine was going to annihilate his people if he did not help them. I come to tell you, you better put your eyes on the right thing and recognize the right enemy and recognize the right kind of attack that you need to launch. Amen. Because you, if you're not right in your mind, if you're not right in your spirit, amen, you will attack the wrong thing. Amen. But praise be to God. Amen. I know, amen, that God has blessed me. God has allowed me to go through all these things. Amen. And it's for my good. I say it's for my good. That is the melting majesty of God. melted majesty. You have to take that thing that is an idol in your life, and you need to melt it down. Come on, somebody. You need to take that thing that's an obstacle in your life, and you need to bring it down. First of all, tear it down. And recognize it's going to be a commitment, because I know the war went over with them tearing that down. It was a 7-year fight. Come on, somebody. I say it was a 7-year fight. But it started with a declaration. And it started, amen, in their hearts when they tore down that statue. Come on, amen. In this season, it's time to tear down some statues. It's time to tear down some statues. It's time to tear down some stuff that's been holding you. It's time to tear down some stuff that you've been beholden and being intimidated by. Amen. Somebody say, no more intimidation. No more intimidation. Amen. No more bowing down in fear. Amen. No more tax paying to bring. Come on. No more giving up our goods to bring. Amen. But it's time, amen, to tear down the statue. No more, amen, walking around, amen, thinking, amen, God has not done enough. Amen. No, no, if you got God on the inside, you already enough. Come on. I said you already enough. And so when I say saints, amen, thy kingdom come, amen, it is us. The devil has used so much to pine us. I say the devil has used so much to pine us. But somebody know I'm a kingdom kid. I'm a kingdom child, amen. I'm a kingdom warrior. I'm in the kingdom, amen, as a representative of the kingdom. I hold my head up. As part of the kingdom, amen, I walk in picture of the Holy Ghost. Amen. Hello, it's kingdom time. Come on. It's kingdom time. It's kingdom time. Amen. Moses didn't never stop him.
Jesus.
Come on.
Thank you.
I don't know Moses had a problem, man.
Yeah.
I said Moses had a problem. Moses had a speech impediment. And when God told him to talk, he told God, I can't talk to these people, amen. I don't have a good speech. I don't talk well. Amen. God said, I got that covered already. Amen. I know God already got it covered. He said, I got it covered. I'm going to use your brother-in-law, amen. He's going to be your mouthpiece. Amen. But I want you to speak. I come to tell you, amen, God's got you covered. In his shortcomings, everybody not perfect, but in his shortcomings you got, amen, listen, God's got it covered. Come on. Amen. I say, God's got it covered. Amen. Somebody say, thy kingdom come. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done. Amen. I know we need the will of God in the earth. Amen. I'll wrap it up, but we need the will of God in the earth. We need God to do a great thing. We need God's anointing in the earth right now. Amen. And so we pray to God, amen, thy kingdom come. That needs to be a kingdom in the nation. Thank you, Jesus. Somebody say, thank you, Jesus. Somebody say, thy kingdom come. Thy kingdom come. Amen. Saints of God, I'm praying for the kingdom. I'm praying for the anointing of the Holy Ghost. I'm praying for people to feel the Spirit of God when I walk by. Come on. When I'm in the room, the atmosphere hasn't changed. Yes, it hasn't changed for the better. Come on, we bring a bad atmosphere. But I come to tell you, man, when you got the Holy Ghost and you come in the room, it ought to be an atmosphere to change. Come on, it ought to be an atmosphere to change, amen. We ought to begin to ask the Lord to help us. God, even if I don't open my mouth, let there be an atmosphere to change. Let there be a shifting of what's going on, even in the room, Lord. Let people feel your anointing. Let people feel your spirit. Let somebody walk up behind me in the grocery store and say there's something different here. Amen. Let me talk to the cat.
they say there's something different here. Let me talk about work. And they say there's something different here. But I don't know what I'm about to inquire, I'm about to find out what this is. Thy kingdom come. Thy kingdom come. But when I speak, the kingdom flows from my mouth. Yes, that when I drive, I'm giving God praise. Come on, amen. If somebody go thumping down the road with their music, come on, you can give God praise in your car.
Amen.
Come on, anybody ride by somebody that is going crazy? Are you wondering what's going on over there? You know what? They're not ashamed. I said, they're not ashamed of it. Amen. So I'm not being ashamed to raise my hand in my car. Amen. You gonna know what I'm doing too, amen. I'm worshiping God. Amen. I will raise my hand, amen, with one hand. Come on. And I'll raise my hand. I'll keep one on the wheel. I'm gonna keep one on the wheel. But I'm gonna be praying, amen. I'm gonna keep one on the wheel, but I'm gonna raise my hand, amen, as I worship my God, because he's good all the time. Amen. He's good on the highway. He's worthy on the highway. He's worthy on the road. Wherever I am. Amen. God is good. And I can bring out a praise at any time. I can bring out a praise at any time. Amen. Because that is kingdom that is in me operating. Amen. Don't just let your kingdom operate in church. Amen. We don't want this to operate in church. Gathering. Amen. We want the kingdom to operate outside the house. Come on, somebody. Somebody say, thy kingdom come. Thy kingdom come. We're going to pray in the name of Jesus. Amen. For the kingdom of God. Amen. The kingdom of God is in you. It is in you. Amen. We're going to pray now. We're going to pray that every majesty is melted. Every high place is brought down. Every valley is filled. Amen. So that when we go forth, we'll operate in full kingdom power. In the name of Jesus. Let us bow. Amen. Let us pray in the name of Jesus. Amen. As we prepare to get. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Melted majesties. They must come down. They must come down. God, in the name of Jesus. Yes, you have allowed us to come together here. I thank you for each one that is present, physically, oh God, and those who are joining us by Facebook. God, I thank you for them right now. I pray that your word has been able to penetrate and to saturate the heart on this day. Thank you for your word. Thank you for your people. God, I pray against every high place. I pray against every exalted thing, God. I pray against every hindrance that is upon us in the name of Jesus. I pray, God, for us to be able to walk in your spirit and under your anointing. God, give us a fresh anointing right now in the name of Jesus. Give us a fresh flow of your spirit, oh God, as we gather in Jesus' name. God, help us and give us the answer in this generation, at this time, Lord. Oh God, for all the problems and the issues that are facing our families and our nation, even across the world. God, give us answers, oh God. Give us the ability, oh God, to bring yokes in the name of Jesus. And even, God, help us to have, God, those things that the enemy used against us. Help us to turn it around, help God, and make something out. In the name of Jesus, help us to turn it, oh God, and use it against the enemy who sought to destroy us. Use it against the enemy who sought to bring us down. And in the name of Jesus, we claim the victory. Oh God, in the name of Jesus, we believe and we trust you that it shall come to pass in Jesus' name. That these things shall come to pass. Somebody say, shall come to pass. Jesus. Amen. Yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Amen. There is an anointing that we have not seen yet.
Yes.
There is the power that we have not fully tapped into yet. But God, at this time, will manifest in a whole new way through his people. We will not bow. We will not be bound, but we will be free in the Holy Ghost. Free to give God praise. Free to lift our voice. Free to lift our hand. Free to deposit into someone else. Come on, this is our time. This is our time. It's time to shine now. Yes, look at somebody say, it's time to shine. Thank you, Jesus. It's time to shine. It's time to go forth in Jesus' name. I thank God for you for joining us. Amen. One more time. Amen. Again, be with us this Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. May the Lord bless you again. Our number three is 803-727-6117. Amen. 803-727-6117.